Detroit, Michigan, once one of the largest cities in America. In 1950, the city was the fifth largest in the nation, at 1.85 million people. But today, in 2019, the city sits at number 23. In this video, we will look at what happened to Detroit, Michigan, and why has it fallen so far from its peak. Most cities in the Rust Belt have experienced declines. Cleveland, Buffalo, Cincinnati, St. Louis, Chicago, all of these have experienced major population losses in the last half century. There are others, however, there is not one more significant and glaring as Detroit, Michigan, which over nearly 70 years has declined down to a third of its former population peak. But why has this happened? Why has Detroit experienced such a larger decline than other cities? Well, the first reason is a lack of diversified industry. Most Rust Belt cities relied on the auto industry. Detroit almost solely relied on the auto industry. And with the rise of GM, Ford, and Chrysler through the first half of the 20th century, Detroit was the place to be. Good-paying union jobs were plentiful, and people could support families without worrying about wages. While the competition from foreign automakers such as Toyota and Honda were basically non-existent compared to today. As more competitors entered the market, the demand for Detroit-made cars lessened. Automation also continued to grow, and outsourcing of American-made cars began. Much of what was previously a Detroit-made car is now made in Canada and Mexico. With the jobs leaving, so did the people. And in Detroit's case, an area so vast has been left behind to rot. City services cannot maintain the large land area of Detroit. Detroit's large land area has left urban prairies, abandoned buildings, and wild dog packs. The auto industry was not the only reason Detroit experienced decline. There was much social and racial tension in the city. There were riots, and there was business and white flight. The level of income between a given area in one part of Detroit and another is large. Poverty, tension, and job loss all led to an increased crime rate in the city. And eventually, the city services could not maintain such a large area. The loss in property tax revenue, combined with the fact that the city had to spend money to maintain such a large area that people were no longer living in, combined with the fact that many payroll-taxed jobs left the city, all contributed to Detroit filing bankruptcy in 2013. Many structures exist still in Detroit that symbolize the decline. Michigan Central Station, once a hub of activity throughout the state and the city, has sat abandoned for over 25 years. The Packard plant, once a hub for jobs and commerce, has sat abandoned for over 50 years. The Vanity Ballroom, once a place where people could gather and enjoy time together, has also sat abandoned for over 50 years. Some Rust Belt cities have been able to find ways to improve. Detroit is somewhat finding their way, but it still has a long way to go. Entrepreneurs such as Detroit's own Dan Gilbert have led this effort. CEO of Quicken Loans, he moved his headquarters to downtown Detroit in 2010 with 1,700 employees. Now, that total has reached 17,000. This is just one example of a possible revival in Detroit. Other projects such as Ford Field and Comerica Park in the early 2000s have helped the city as well. It remains to be seen if the population losses can stop or maybe turn around in Detroit. The fact is, Detroit's overdependence on the auto industry led to its decline and is the cause of many other things that led to its decline. Many Rust Belt cities' population losses have leveled off, yet Detroit continues to drop. When and if these losses ever do level off will be a sign of when Detroit will really begin to turn around. For now, time will tell Detroit's fate. As always, thank you for watching.